Greetings for the day, students. I would like to discuss about it is useful for both senior secondary and secondary resolution of vectors. This is a basic tool for physics, those who are preparing for NEET and JEE. While you are going through wedge problems or force related for problems in mechanics as well as in electricity, it's a tool. But in this, many students will confuse if they want to find relation between the forces horizontally, vertically. Whenever we need to resolve a force that may weight or tension, we'll get confusion which is horizontal component, which is vertical component. Students blindly they'll remember basic diagram by using basic diagram. Sine means horizontal, cos means vertical. But we have to realize simple thing, sine and cos are coming from theta. Theta adjacent side is cos, theta opposite side is sine. Simple example, what is resolution of vector means? A vector has components, it may two dimensional or three dimensional. A vector have components, that components vectorially if you add means again you will get the former vector. Let us consider simple diagram. Here A is a vector, here I am writing A is a vector in the plane, this A is a vector A. This A vector is making an angle theta with the x axis here theta. A vector I am able to write two components. How it means? By using this diagram, by simple trigonometry, I can write this is A cos theta and here it is A sin theta. A cos theta, A sin theta. Here only students they are confusing. How can you write here cos theta means this y axis parallel to this here in this triangle, this is theta means OPQ. OP is adjacent side, PQ is opposite side, and OQ is hypotenuse. By using that, I wrote. Obviously, everyone knows that cos theta, trigonometric ratios, cos means adjacent side by hypotenuse, sine means opposite by hypotenuse. The simple formula we can use and we wrote. Same way. Here I want to write this resolution of vector. Resolution of vector resultant is equal to A sin theta I, A sin theta j plus A cos theta I. I wrote. Means A is a vector. I wrote into two components, A cos theta and A sin theta. I wrote in resultant vector is A sin theta j plus A cos theta I, because here cos theta is along x axis, that's why I took I, and here it is A sin theta y axis, I took y axis j. If I want to get a resultant vector, I can get easily. I want resultant r is equal to root over A sin theta whole square plus A cos theta the whole square. Again I can get original vector A, means resultant is A. Means a vector split into two or three components, independent components. Here you see A cos theta is horizontal component, here A sin theta is vertical component. Those two are mutually perpendicular, that's why those are called independent. A cos theta never depend on A sin theta, or A sin theta never depend on A cos theta. Vector is resolved means, resolution means splitting. A vector splitting into components. We split it into two components. I wrote A cos theta, A sin theta. Vectorially I am adding means I am getting again A cos theta, A sin theta. Resultant again I am getting A. Resultant vector A here. Why? Because I took here A is vector. Similarly, same diagram where students are confusing. Suppose this is the A vector here in this plane.
rectangular coordinate system. This is a vector here, a vector. Now, and instead of here, I need a given here. Here I want to write a vector into two components, a cos theta as well as a sin theta. How I can write? Students, obviously what they will do mistake, you know. Here they write a cos theta, here they write a sin theta. That's why what I am giving clarity, even those who are good in subject, those who are preparing for NEET JEE also, they are doing mistake here. Should not write here a cos theta. Here theta means theta adjacent side is here. Theta opposite side here. This is opposite side means x axis and this is parallel. That's why here if you draw dotted line, this is a sin theta. This is a cos theta. Former diagram, this is a cos theta, this is a sin theta. But now in this diagram, this is a cos theta, this is a sin theta. That we have to know where we are writing. Angle which is adjacent side, which is opposite side. Whenever you are writing mathematics, good basic, those who are having, they won't struggle. Those who are lagging mathematics, they'll struggle. But if you remember that whenever we are writing angle, theta adjacent is cos, opposite is sine, we can resolve easily. Now here also we can write resultant vector A is equal to, here what happened? A cos theta j plus a sin theta j plus I. See, students, you have to remember previous diagram, previous one, resolution of vector. Here we got a sin theta j plus a cos theta I. But when orientation of angle changed, here this is r is equal to a cos theta j plus a sin theta I. Means like this, it is changing. Like this angular orientation of angle is changing, means obviously resolution of vector also changed. This is simple basic. Now I will take one example. One example I will take. What is that mean, sir? A force of 30 Newton is acting on an object. Find horizontal component of force. A force of 30 Newton acting on a object as shown. Find horizontal and vertical, horizontal and vertical components. This example, a force of 30 Newton acts on an object as shown in the figure. Find the horizontal and vertical. How to find? This is the object diagram. This is the diagram. Here force acting. Here 30 Newton force acting. Here it is making 30 degrees. Here we have to use a resolution of vector. The force of 30 Newton acting as shown in the figure. I want to calculate horizontal component and vertical component. How to calculate? Simple students. Here we have to form a triangle. Which triangle? Just this is side, this side 30 Newton acting. It is making an angle 30 degrees here. Force, horizontal component means here fx. Vertical component means this is fy. This is fy. Fx, fy. Now, from the diagram, adjacent side is this side, down. If you label O, P, Q, OP is adjacent side, PQ is opposite side, and QO is hypotenuse. From here, Fx you want means Fx is equal to, and Fx is equal to 30 cos 30. 30 cos 30. 30 cos 30. From this here, fx is equal to 30 cos 30 is root 3 by 2. That gives 15 root 3 newton.
Means sir, horizontal component is 15 root 3 newton.
Similarly, vertical component you want to calculate, that is Fy is equal to 30 sin 30. 30 into sin 30 is 1 by 2. As we know that, then from here, this gives 15 newton.
Means, here we are applying, 30 newton force, making 30 degrees with the horizontal.
When we are resolving the vector components, this is Fy is vertical component, Fx is horizontal component, Fy is 30 sin 30, Fx is 30 root 3 by 2, 15 root 3, this value is
15 root 3. Similar, one more example, where student will confuse, that's why I want to discuss examples only.
Same question is same, data is same, but now I want to take one more diagram. That diagram is like this. Object is here. Now force is acting in this way, but what is my intention here? Angle is there. Here 60 newton force is there.
60 newton force is acting.
The 60 newton force diagram is like this. Here it is acting force. Here 60 newton force. 60 degrees. Here 60 newton force is acting.
Here also I want to calculate both horizontal and vertical components. How to find components? We'll see here. Here also, again students. Sir, horizontal component means always x-axis only. Vertical component means always y-axis only. But don't fix horizontal means cos, vertical means sin. Try to remove that. Now from the diagram,
here this is a force acting direction. Here is making an angle 60 degrees. Here force is active. If here force is acting, that is 60 newton. That is a 60 newton force is acting here. 60 newton.
Now, when we are resolving, here who is adjacent side, who is opposite side, if we conclude, easy. Our task is easy.
Now, 60 degree adjacent side is here. This we can write 60 cos 60. Here it is 60 sin 60, opposite side.
When we are writing,
if x is equal to now here 60 sin 60, this is 60 sin 60 is root 3 by 2. That gives 30 root 2 newton.
30 root 2 newton. See here. Before diagram, if we go before diagram, horizontal who came? Vertical who came?
Here we see.
According to the orientation of angle, horizontal becomes vertical, vertical becomes horizontal, that value. But horizontal means x, vertical means y. But while we are writing angle, adjacent is cos, opposite is sin. That you should not forget while resolving vector.
Now here, similarly, Fy is equal to 60 cos 60, 60 into cos 60 is 1 by 2. That gives 30 newton. Means
60 newton force, how it is resolving it components means
30 root 2 acting along x axis,
30 newton is acting along y axis. And one more, last one.
This is just in the case of force. Suppose. Very easy one, next one.
easy one and a good one. I am explaining next one. What does that mean, sir? A simple pendulum is hanging vertically. Some horizontal force, suppose two pendulums are there, two pendulums having charge QQ. If they are repulsive force acting, means they will move from vertical position. They will go some height h. When it is going, how to get the relation between the forces? Suppose a simple pendulum is hanging in the hanging here. The simple pendulum is hanging. Suppose this scale you take, vertical scale. Scale is hanging like this. Scale is now went this much height. I want to here. I pushed some force. I applied some force with my hand. How much force I applied? I want to calculate relation means by using the solution of vector. Easily we can get the relation. How means? Simply first a simple pendulum is hanging in such a way. In this way, simple pendulum is hanging. Now, if we apply some force, if I apply some force means it went to this side, this much side. What I applied means I applied a F force here. I applied a force here. It went in this direction. Now, this is making some angle. This is making some angle theta with the vertical. This is making some angle theta with the vertical. Now, how many forces are acting here? Means the simple pendulum ball having mass m. Because of mass m here, mg is acting downward. I want to get relation between my applied force and weight. How much weight is simple pendulum? How much applied force I want relation? But what I have to do means when pendulum bob is hanging downward, in that string there is a force. Such a force is called as tensional force. Here tensional force is acting upward. Immediately what we have to do? We have to go for resolution of vector. I am drawing one dotted line here, like this dotted line. Now this angle and this angle are same. Opposite angles are same here. This angle is same. Now tension I am resolving into two components. Tension here, this is hypotenuse side is tension. Here you can write T cos theta. Here it is T sin theta. T cos theta, T sin theta. Obviously, if you see the diagram, we got all the forces. How many forces are acting on the string means in this direction. Block, just I draw the block diagram here. This is the mass m. Upward is T cos theta. I applied force is F hardened in this direction. Tension resolved this direction T sin theta. And mg is acting downward. Mg is acting downward. Now we got all the forces acting on the body. T sin theta is horizontally negative x axis. T cos theta upward, mg downward, and applied force is x axis. You got all the forces. Now, if you know all these forces, we have to go for what I said already starting by using resolution of vector. I want to find the how much force I need to apply to raise the pendulum this much height. To raise the pendulum this much height. Now, it is equilibrium condition. Equilibrium means T cos theta. T cos theta is equal to mg. T sin theta is equal to f. If you square and add them, squaring and adding means again tension will be in the equation. Here only students again confusion. Physics means immediately thought should come. If I am squaring and adding means cos sin I can remove, but tension will be in the equation. We don't know how much tension. That's why instead of that you take ratio T sin theta upon T cos theta is equal to F by Mg. Tension cancelling this. Tan theta is equal to F by Mg. Therefore, F is equal to Mg tan theta. Okay, F is equal to Mg tan theta. See, to raise pendulum this much height, how much force I needed means F is equal to Mg tan theta. That is proportional to the angle here. How much height you want to raise, that much force we have to apply. Do see and give comments, good comments, and share this. And in next video, I'll give very wonderful topic. This is resolution of vector. Next, I'll give wonderful topic. Thank you.